You're probably wondering why I am wearing this white coat. We'll get into that too. Hi everyone and welcome to Pal to Tech. If you look on the X-T3 and X-T4, you'll see that it offers a choice of 420 or 422. What exactly does that mean? Glad you asked. These numbers and the way they appear in your camera menu are a way of explaining how your Fujifilm camera is performing chroma subsampling. Camera manufacturers such as Fujifilm are in a constant battle to make sure that the size of these video files, you know, the ones that are stored on the SD card, are as small as possible. Chroma subsampling is a technique that your camera uses to help reduce your video file size by throwing away color information. To best understand chroma subsampling, we're going to use a special standard grid of reference that contains 8 pixels from your video. These pixels are in a grid, 4 pixels across by 2 pixels up and down. This same 4x2 chart is used by all manufacturers, by the way, when referring to how much chroma subsampling their cameras are performing. Now, each pixel in your image contains both luma values and color values. Because your eyes are much more sensitive to luma, and so luma is never thrown away. Luma values are never thrown away. However, changes in color, those can be fudged with a little bit. And Fuji and other camera manufacturers use a 3-digit indicator to tell you how much they are reducing the individual colors. You see it in the video settings right here where some of the numbers look like 420 and others look like 422. It's in the format of 3 digits separated by colons and directly references this 4x2 chart. The first number represents the luma value and it always remains at 4. There is always a luma value in every pixel of your footage. The second number is color information in the top row of these 2 rows right here. Because we're looking at the highest quality possible image, there are 4 different colors in the top row, and thus it shows the number 4. The third number is the color information for the second row. As before, because there is a number 4 listed, this means that all 4 pixels in the second row have their own individual color. So, 444 means that each pixel has a separate luma value and a separate color value for the top row and the bottom row as well. Now, let's take a look at 422, which is a setting option on the X-T3 and the X-T4 camera for video shooting. With 422, the camera is only capturing 1/2 the color resolution. With regard to color, instead of each pixel being its own thing, every other pixel is instead duplicated across. So you're now only capturing 1/2 the color information. These groups of pixels are being lazy and just copying over their color data. And lastly, with 420, you are only getting 1/4 of the color resolution from the original 444. In the case of 420, your camera is first doing the exact same thing it did with 422. In other words, just making a carbon copy of every other color. Same thing. The difference now is in the second row. In the second row, there's no new color information at all being captured. None. Zero. Rather, the color information in the first row is being duplicated to the second row. What a sneaky trick. Okay, right here I shot 2 different takes of the same footage with similar camera settings, and as you sort of scroll through the footage right here and look at it, it's really hard to tell the difference between the two. This is Eterna right out of the camera, and the only thing that I did was I added a little bit of color to it, I increased the saturation, but that's it. Let's now go to 200%. So again, straight out of the camera, they look very similar because I haven't applied any color correction. I'm really not doing doing much with it because a lot of the color information is already baked into the footage. Now let's go over here. In this case, I shot in F-Log. Think of it as a raw format for video. So I shot this in F-Log. In this case, I need to apply a lookup table or a LUT. And Fujifilm does make the eternal LUT available for download and you can apply it right here. If I just look at the raw F-Log footage, I don't see that much of a difference. Now, I am going to apply a lookup table and also apply some basic color grading. I just did that to the footage that's on the left, which is the 8-bit footage. Next, I'm gonna do the exact same settings, the exact same grading to the 10-bit 422 footage. Let me bring them a little closer together and I am going to zoom in, talk about pixel peeping with video. Okay, have a look at this. So the 8-bit 420 footage shows a little bit of banding. It doesn't look as good. There's not as much color information to work with. Whereas look at the 10-bit. It just looks better overall. Do you see that? And that's what the difference is when you're going into post-production and trying to color grade your footage. When you do that, you wanna have more color information. The more, the better. Where both the bit depth and the chroma subsampling really matter is when you're color grading your footage, adding digital effects, and applying lookup tables or LUTs. If you're not doing any of these things, then I doubt you're gonna see much difference when straight out of the camera video footage, particularly if you're just posting it online somewhere. Something I think a lot of people seem to forget is that just because you don't do something or know how to do something today, doesn't mean that you won't be doing it or acquiring the skill tomorrow. And once you shoot your footage, that's it, it's forever. So my overall general recommendation is to always shoot the best footage you can, taking into account your computer's processing power and storage space. In other words, I recommend that unless you have a real good reason not to, go ahead and shoot in 10-bit 422. One day, you may want to go back and add some color grading or do something with regard to processing your digital footage, and you'll be very glad that you have that extra color information with it. Now, I promised I would tell you why I'm wearing this silly white lab coat. This is the second time today I've shot this entire video. I spent half the day setting up and shooting an entire segment. I had the lab coat on, I thought I would be funny, but once I finished shooting and I had wrapped for the day and I brought all that footage back into my editing software, I saw that those weird prop glasses, those black glasses that I was wearing, were distracting because they were bouncing one of my overhead lights right off the glasses, right into the camera, and that bothered me so much that I ditched all of the footage and everything and ended up coming back in here into the studio to do the reshoot. And I was so annoyed at having to reshoot the entire video all over again. So I kept this silly coat on all day and it gave me the motivation to end up doing this second shoot. YouTube is hard. It really is. It's hard. Yeah, anyway, I really hope you like this video. Because I had to do it twice. If you did, please consider giving it the like and subscribe. And of course, I will see you in another video again real soon. Take care. So here you have 8 pixels. And each pixel also has a luminance value.